used as a device, and we will cover two types of devices. One is we can use it as switch, and we can use it for as amplifier. These are two kind of a devices which can be made using the transistor. It can be used for switching of circuit and for amplification of signal, and both these we can do using common emitter configuration. So first let us take up a circuit with common emitter, and we'll first cover the working of transistor as a switch. The basics first, draw the symbol of transistor. Let us take NPN. This is base. This is collector, and this is emitter. We are having common emitter, so this is common. You may like to go through the lecture on common characteristics of common emitter transistor. That will clarify the basics, because I will not be covering all those things here, because the topic is confined to transistor as a switch and as amplifier. As a symbol of transistor is concerned, always draw an arrow between base and emitter, and arrow has to be from P to N. Had it been PNP, had it been P here, N here, then arrow would have been like this. So don't think that arrow is from base to emitter. Arrow is between base to emitter, but from P to N. So it depends what kind of transistor you are using. We are using NPN transistor, that is why this kind of thing we have done. Now, we will provide, there is an resistance here, we call it as RB, and we provide this voltage, we call it as VBB. There will be some current here, IB. This is forward biased, you can see. This is forward bias. We have provided positive here, negative here. For forward bias, P side has to be connected to positive, N side to negative. This we will provide reverse bias between collector and base. For reverse biasing, the N has to have higher voltage than P. Means the voltage which is given to the collector should be such, between collector and emitter the voltage has to be such that if you provide one resistance here as RC or RL, you can call it by any name, this voltage has to be enough that you provide a higher potential here as compared to this point. So this voltage has to be higher than this voltage, so that you have a higher potential, relatively higher. Potential is all about the relative. If suppose here it is 6 volt, here it is 3 volt, then it is at higher potential and it will be forward bias. Suppose here it is 1 volt and here it is 3 volt again, then this is at higher potential and it will be forward bias. That is not we want. We have to reverse bias collector base and forward bias base emitter. Now this voltage we will take as VCE, this total voltage, and this voltage is VBE, and this is VCB, and this is VBE. This voltage, and this will be VBE. Let us apply the Kirchhoff's law for this loop and this loop. Here you have IC flowing, collector current, and here you have base current, here you have emitter current. Let us apply Kirchhoff's law here. this VBB will be equal to RBIB, this voltage drop here, IBRB, plus this voltage drop, which is VBE. This is one part. Now take this side, the collector side, apply the Kirchhoff's law. IC is flowing through RC, there is VCC here, there is a voltage drop here, so this voltage will be this voltage minus this drop. So VCE would be equal to VCC minus IC RC, or I could have written this VCC is equal to VCE plus IC RC, so that we maintain the similarity between the manner in which the equation is written for this side and that side. Now, if we take this as the input voltage, this as the input voltage, VI, this as the input voltage, and we take this as the output voltage. What is the output voltage? Will be VCE is equal to VCC minus IC and RC. This is the output voltage. This is the output, we will say. This is VO, VCE and VO are same, so we can write output voltage as VO is equal to VCC minus ICRC, and this we will write as input voltage VI is equal to VBB minus IBRB. We know that when the base emitter voltage is less than 0.6 or 0.7, in some books it is said 0.6, 0.7, it is in this range. When it is less than this, this is not forward biased. To forward bias base emitter junction, you need minimum this much voltage. Less than this voltage, there is no current in this base, there is no current flows because it is not forward biased. If you recall the characteristics of the transistor, the input characteristics were like this. This was 0.6 volt, so less than 0.6 volt there was no current here. So when there is no current here, there is no current in the transistor, this circuit is not complete. When there is no current here, this circuit is not complete, and when there is no current here, IC will be zero. To make current flow through the collector in and through this circuit, the output side, you need minimum biasing, that is 0.7 volt here. Let us assume it is less than 0.7, so this will be zero, so VO would be equal to VCC, so VO is maximum. This state, I will have to rub part of it and now draw this on a graph to show how the transistor works as a switch. Now if we draw a graph like this, this is VI and this is VO. VO was how much? VO was VCC minus ICRC. When VI was less than certain value, say 0.6 volt, there was no collector current and VO is maximum. This is the cutoff region. Transistor is in cutoff. Though it is in cutoff region, but the output is high because output will be same as the voltage you are supplying, VCC you are supplying to the collector. So in cutoff region there is no collector current and the output voltage is highest. When you increase this voltage beyond this volt, there is increase in IC and the drop in VO is almost linear up to a point. Up to a point it is linear, then it is a saturation state where hardly any difference is made to the VO because the current has now, IC has reached the saturation level. So this is the saturation level, this is the cutoff level. This region where the behavior between VO and VI is almost linear is the active region. In the cutoff state output is maximum, in the saturation state output is minimum, VO is minimum. Don't get confused that saturation means high output. High output depends on, I will just redraw this circuit to recapitulate. This circuit was like this output side. This is VCC, this is RC. When the current here is zero, the output voltage is equal to VCC. And when the current here is maximum, the saturation level, the VO is least, VO drops, VO reaches to this level. So this is working like a switch. If we want to use it as a switch, and how do we do that? Let me explain a simple circuit. This is base, this is emitter, this is collector, and symbol is between base and emitter from P to N. This is the arrow mark. You connect this to resistance RB, connect this to voltage VBB, and this is common. We are using common emitter. Here you similarly provide one resistance RL. This is VCC. I am not repeating the biasing, this is forward biased, and this part is reverse biased because of higher voltage being here. I have already explained in this previous part, and here the IC will flow. What do we do? We provide a capacitor here and one input voltage. Input voltage which is of sinusoidal in nature, like this. Capacitor is provided to block the DC current. You can inflow the AC current and DC current is blocked because capacitor doesn't provide you the DC current. Because after saturation, after charging of capacitor, the current, DC current stops flowing, but it doesn't happen with AC current. This will be your output. Circuit is almost same. Now let us apply the Kirchhoff's law here and here. For this part it is V, this is BE, and this is VCE, which is VO. Write the equation without input voltage. Without input voltage the equation is like this. VBB is equal to VBE plus IBRB. When we superimpose input voltage through this capacitor, this becomes VBB plus VI is equal to VBE. This VBE plus IB plus delta IB is the change in current RB, plus there is a dynamic resistance also. If we look at this relationship, delta IB is equal to delta VBE upon RI. If you recall the common emitter characteristics, the input characteristics, so there is a change in voltage delta VBE, which will be written as RI plus into delta IB because of the change in this VI. Now you subtract the upper equation from the lower equation, you get this gets cancelled, and this part is getting cancelled. You get VI is equal to delta IB RB plus RI. This is an important relationship, and we write this as R. We replace this as R. We can write it as VI is equal to delta IB into R. R is RI plus RB. Now let us write the equation for the collector side, the output side. This is VCC. VCC is equal to this drop ICRL, this drop plus this voltage drop plus VCE. This is the relationship for the output side. Now if we differentiate it, at this VCC is constant, so it becomes delta ICRL is equal to minus delta VCE. So we have got delta VCE, which is nothing but VO, output voltage. This is the output voltage. So output voltage is equal to VO is equal to minus delta ICRL. These two are very important. Minus sign is important here, and it is like this. There is a current amplification factor. We write beta AC, which is change in collector current with change in base current, ratio of this. Because it is delta, the change, that is why we write AC here, and beta DC is simply IC upon IB. At any point of time, if collector current is IC and base current is IB, ratio of 2 is beta DC, and beta AC, the current amplification factor, is change in IC with change in IB. And now for voltage amplification, that is, we want in case of amplifier, the voltage amplification is, that is VO upon VI, which is equal to, this will be equal to, what is VO? Is minus delta ICRL. This is VO, and what is VI? Is delta IB into R, where R is RB plus RI. This is what? This is current amplification. So the voltage amplification AV is, for the amplifier, AV is equal to beta AC, that is current amplification, into minus into RL upon R. This is your voltage amplification. And if this, in this particular circuit, when VIE will increase, VO will decrease, but the decrease will be more by a factor. If we go back to the graph, the change will be amplified. How it happens, we can see with very basics. We'll not go to the higher level. Up to 12th level, I think we can consider this diagram again. If this is VI and this is VO. Just recall that graph which we had made for this, the cutoff and saturation. It is slightly steep. This was the cutoff region, this is the saturation region. This is your VI. Let me take a middle point and let a signal be given like this. VI is given here. This is the input signal. And from this I will draw an output. When this is rising, this will change. See, when you are moving in this direction, so graph is moving like this. So corresponding points will be this further low. So it will be like this, and if you draw the output here, I'll show the output here. It is like this, and in amplified, the amplification will depend upon how steep this slope is. More steep, you get more amplification. And just see, it is just the opposite. You can correlate from the graph. When it was rising, this is the middle point. As it rises, the VO is falling. Falling up to this point, it is falling. Now it starts falling. When it starts falling, it moves like this, in this direction. So when it is moving in this direction along the graph, VO is rising. You come to this point. Now VI is falling. VI is falling means you are moving in this direction. In the graph, you will move in this direction, and in this direction VO is increasing. So when it is falling for this region, it is falling. This will be the corresponding region where VO is rising. So it is just the inverse, inverted output and amplified output. And you recall AB was minus beta AC R L upon R. So this is the basics of how transistor can work as a switch and transistor can work as an amplifier. So thank you.